it's not easy. You're not gonna lie and sit here and polish stuff and say it's challenging.
Yeah,
it's a challenge, you know. You get there, you find, you know, people are always gonna underestimate you. When you are young, you know, you are graduate, people think, you know what, we've been doing this for 15 years, and then when now you just come there and you want to tell them what to do. Because at some point, you know, my crew, the average age is about 43, you know. And you get there and you know, sometimes you have a person who's as old as your father, and then you have to tell him what to do, how you present yourself, you know, respect, how you keep time, soft skills, you know, the people skills, how you communicate, presentation skills. Those are the things that they were looking at.
You know, like the importance of earthquake and how while you're still in university, you can attain experience. So that by the time you graduate, at least you have some sort of experience and you know the environment that you're going to be working at, like for probably for the rest of your life. So how important is earthquake to you guys, and how did it prepare you guys for the industry?
You get to be exposed to what you are going, you know, to be based on, you know, for like what Cesar said, when he went there for the first time, you know, I was expecting it was just a quick get in. I mean, you get to understand. And then it also helps you to decide which industry you want to. Is it a coal industry?
Okay.
Do you want to do hard rock, platinum, gold, diamond? So when you do VEC work, then you get to see, you know, how it has evolved mining. You know, when someone thinks of mining, they think of a pick and a shovel, and they think that's mining, which is not, you know. It's quite a complex thing. There's a whole lot of machinery, you know, people. It's a very complex system, but it's doable, and we have fun doing it. You know, we enjoy it. You know, it's something which we chose. Even in an interview, when you go for an interview, you know, when you walk in and you shake people's hand, have a firm handshake, keep eye contact, small things, you know, be audible when you talk, you know, show confidence, you know, even when you're presenting, and you, especially when you're presenting about yourself, because in an interview you're presenting about yourself.
Yeah, I have to be confident about yourself.
So if you don't show confidence when you're talking about yourself, then how is a person supposed to hire you and represent other people with different personalities if you're not even, you know, confident about your own personality? So for me, in terms of VEC work, I would say soft skills. It's a very good opportunity to develop and exercise your soft skills. Communication, presenting, those things. You know, to be a production manager, GM, and so forth, there's no other certificate. It ends with the mine manager certificate. Hence the difficulty, because you know, that one is a tough one to get. You know, it takes a couple of attempts for most of the people.
For me, I would advise any person that would like to do a mining engineering to maybe do a bit of research about it, be sure what you want to get yourself into, maybe get some bit of exposure, then you can finally like say that I know I want to do mining engineering.
Okay,
because I've seen like a whole lot of people who studied mining engineering without having to go underground. Then you find out that when you're in your third year, you go underground for the first time, then you're really not comfortable with the environment. You really don't like it.
Then you have to change course. You see. Yeah. And after 3 years,
you see.
You can imagine.
So.